You are listening to the voice of the gospel, a proclamation of the Holy Scripture by Wisdom Ministries.
March 14th, fourth Sunday of Lent. Let's begin this day with the blessings of God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John chapter 3 verses 14 to 21. Just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Those who believe in him are not condemned, but those who do not believe are condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and people loved darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For all who do evil hate the light and do not come to the light, so that their deeds may not be exposed. But those who do what is true come to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that their deeds have been done in God. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear friends, at first one might wonder at the choice of the first reading and what its relevance might be to Lent, let alone the Gospel. Because of the sins of the Jewish people, from the priests down, because the idolatry and the other shameful and the sacrilegious practices, and after God sent the messenger after messenger who were not listened to, a terrible punishment fell on the people. This is how the sacred writer understands the destruction of the temple and the whole city of Jerusalem, and the survivors being carried off to Babylon and exiled by Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon. Many years later, Cyrus, the king of Persia, became the agent of God, by which God's people were once more able to return to Jerusalem and began to rebuild their traditions and the new temple. Jesus, an agent of God. The Gospel has a parallel theme, but on much higher level. Jesus, the Son of God, becomes the agent of God's salvation, not just for one sinful people, but for the sinfulness of all world. On this fourth Sunday of Lent, we are coming closer to the celebration of how that salvation was brought about. The Gospel makes a comparison with Moses, who was also an agent of God, and a savior of God's people. The Israelites in the desert had been complaining bitterly about their conditions. So they were punished by a plague of serpent, and many died. Numbers 21:4-9. At God's instruction, Moses raised up a bronze serpent on a pole, and whenever anyone who had been bitten by a serpent looked at the bronze serpent, he recovered. Yes, John sees here a fourth type of Jesus being lifted up. For John, Jesus being lifted up includes both his being raised up on the cross and being raised up to be with his Father in glory. In the process, we were saved, healed, and made whole. All those who look up to Jesus in faith will be saved, will be given eternal life, a life that never can be taken away. Yes. And all of this is a sign of God's own love. God sacrificed his only Son so that we might have that eternal life. He emphasizes that God sent his Son to save and not to judge or condemn. In fact, no one who puts their whole self in God's hands through faith can be condemned. And it is never too late to make that step of faith. Darkness of chosen evil. On the other hand, whoever refuses to believe is already condemned. This is not at all directed to those who sincerely follow another faith, another religion, another vision of life. Judgment and condemnation happen where people prefer darkness to light. as indicated by lives of evil and immoral behavior, hate instead of love, vengeance instead of forgiveness, greed instead of sharing, taking instead of giving life. Yes, my friends. Fear of being judged. Fear of being judged. However, there is another kind of darkness in which people live. It is a darkness of shame when there is something in their lives which they would like to share but are not able to bring out into the open. The reason is their fear of judgment, rejection, and ridicule by others. One thinks of a young girl who finds herself pregnant but has no one to turn to, least of all members of her own family or sometimes even member of the church. One thinks of a young man who discovers he or she is homosexual and is condemned to live in the darkness of the closest, terrified to come out even to or especially to family and friends. These are two examples. In these cases, the agents of darkness are those who sit in judgment. They themselves are living in darkness of prejudice and hate, usually the symptoms of an inner fear and inner insecurity. But as the second reading reminds us today, all our goodness is God's gift to us. And it's nothing for us to boast about. Our goodness, such as it is His goodness shining through us. Let us then look at Jesus lifted up on the cross and in glory. Let us see the colossal love of God for us shown there. Let us open our hearts to that love and let it flow right through us to bring life and hope to others. Amen. May God bless us.